सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति 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 हरि ओम। भगवद गीता 14th चैप्टर 16th वर्स। कर्मणः सुकृतस्याहुः सात्विकं निर्मलं फलं रजसस्तु फलं दुःखं अज्ञानं तमसः फलं। नौ नौ द डिफरेंट फ्रूट्स ऑफ एक्शंस प्रोपेल्ड बाय डिफरेंट गुनास दे आर बीइंग डिस्क्राइब्ड। सुकृतस्य गुड कर्मण है ऑफ एक्शन, निर्मलम प्योर, सात्विकम सात्विक फलम द फ्रूट, आहु हु देसे देसे हु सेस देसे मीन्स पीपल हु नो द ट्रूथ, पीपल हु नो अबाउट द फंक्शंस ऑफ द थ्री गुणस दे टेल दिस। एंड रजस है ऑफ रजस टू इंडीड दुखम पेन फलम is the fruit, and then tamasah tamas of tamas ajnanam ignorance phalam is the result, is the fruit. So the fruit of good action is pure and sattvika. That means good action produces sattvika, action produces good and pure results. Sattvic action produces good and pure results. And also rajasic action. Rajasic action, when we say sattvic action or rajasic or tamasic action, we should understand that actions which are done with a predominance of sattva, rajas or tamas. And when we say predominance of sattva, rajas and tamas, then sattva qualities, where sattva qualities are more, or rajas, rajasic qualities are more, or tamasic qualities are more. That is what we are hinting at. So, rajasastu phalam dukkham ajnanam tamasa phalam. The result of rajasic actions, is always dukkham, pain. Result of rajasic actions is always pain. And tamasa, ajnanam tamasa phalam. The result of tamas is always ignorance. So, why is rajasic action leading to dukkha or pain or misery or suffering? Because it is characterized by longing, desire, greed. So, Ashahi paramam dukkham, Nairashyam paramam sukham. So, Asha or longing, expectation is the greatest misery. You expect, you will suffer. If you don't expect, you will not suffer. Nairashyam paramam sukham, non-attached behavior, non-attachment, or non-expectation is the greatest paramam sukham, greatest happiness. So, if you expect something, then definitely there will be unhappiness, there will be pain, there will be misery. Sattvat sanjayate jnanam, rajaso lobha evacha, pramada mohau tamaso, bhavato ajnanam evacha. Sattvat, from sattva, Jnanam, wisdom, sanjayate, arises. Rajasaha, from rajas, lobaha, greed, eva, indeed. Cha, and tamasaha, from tamas, ajnanam, ignorance. Pramada mohau, miscomprehension or erroneous understanding, and delusion. Eva, even च एंड भवतः अराइज. सो फ्रॉम सत्वात् संजायते ज्ञानम, फ्रॉम सत्व गुणा अराइजेस नॉलेज विजडम, एंड फ्रॉम रजस अराइजेस ग्रीड मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग रॉन्ग अंडरस्टैंडिंग डेल्यूशन एंड डेल्यूशन एंड इग्नोरेंस इट अराइजेस फ्रॉम तमस. मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग डेल्यूशन एंड इग्नोरेंस अराइजेस फ्रॉम तमस, एंड फ्रॉम रजस अराइजेस ग्रीड. सो सत्व लीड्स टू विजडम, रजस लीड्स टू ग्रीड, एंड तमस लीड्स टू मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग रॉन्ग अंडरस्टैंडिंग डेल्यूशन एंड इग्नोरेंस. ऊर्ध्वं गच्छन्ति सत्वस्थ मध्ये तिष्ठन्ति राजसाः जगन्य गुणवृत्तिस्थ अधो गच्छन्ति तामसः. सो दिस इज अ फिगरेटिव विजुअल काइंड ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ व्हाट हैपेंस टू पीपल हु आर हैविंग अ प्रेडोमिनेंस ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर गुण. सत्वस्थः द पीपल हु आर एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन सत्व लिटरली और who are abiding in sattva or who have a predominance of sattva guna, urdhvam gacchanti, they go upwards. Urdhvam, upwards. That means they progress. Rajasaha, those who have a predominance of rajas, they madhye tishtanti, they madhye in the middle, they are tishtanti dwelling. And jaganya guna vrittisthaha, those who are abiding in the function of the lowest guna, तामसाः द तामसिका अगः अधः डाउनवर्ड्स गच्छन्ति. सो अधः गच्छन्ति दोस हु हैव अ प्रेडोमिनेंस, दोस हु हैव अ प्रेडोमिनेंस ऑफ तमोगुण दे गो डाउनवर्ड्स, दे गो डाउनवर्ड्स एंड दे अबाइड इन द फंक्शन ऑफ द जगण्य गुण लोएस्ट गुण and they go downwards. So those who have a predominance of sattva, they go upwards. Those who have a predominance of rajas, they sit in the middle, and those who have a predominance of tamas, they go downwards, adha gacchanti, because they are jaganya guna vrittistha, they are settled in jaganya guna. Jaganya guna, lowest guna. So they are settled in the vritti or the function of the lowest guna. So that is why they go downwards. Adaha gacchanti. So automatically a tier sort of has been created. Sattva is the uppermost tier and rajas is the middle tier and tamas is the lowest tier. So if one has to progress in life, even in material life, one has to be established in sattva-guna. Material life means what? If one has to have happiness in the world or after the world, one has to be established in sattva-guna. Nanyam gunebhyah kartaram yada drashtanu pashyasti गुणेभ्यश्च परम वेति मद्भावं सोधि गच्छति. यदा वेन द्रष्टा द सीयर गुणेभ्यः देन द गुणास अन्यः अन्यम अदर कर्तारम एजेंट न नॉ अनुपश्यति बिहोल्ड्स गुणेभ्यः देन द गुणास च एंड परम हियर वेति नोस तदा देन सह ही मद्भावम माई बीइंग अधिगच्छति अटेन्स टू. सो वेन द द्रष्टा द सीयर गुणेभ्यः अन्यम कर्तारम न अनुपश्यति अंडरस्टैंड्स. अनुपश्यति मीन्स टू सी, बट हियर इट विल मीन अंडरस्टैंड्स. अंडरस्टैंड्स नो एजेंट कर्तारम एजेंट अदर देन द गुणास एंड नोस that gunebhyah cha param veti and also knows that which is beyond gunas, triguna tita, Triguna. Triguna means three gunas. One which is atita, that which is beyond trigunas, triguna atita. So, a person who knows that principle which is beyond the three gunas and also knows that as far as actions are concerned or as far as the phenomena is concerned, there is no other agent other than the three gunas, that person, saha, that person, madbhavam, my being, adigachati, attains to. So that person attains to madbhavam, my being. So when the seer does not see any other agent other than the gunas and knows that which is trigunatita, Brahman, which is the sakshi of the gunas and their functions. So the gunas transform into bodies, senses, sense objects and all the modifications. And so that is, the gunas are essentially the agents. And so a person should know that it is the gunas which are the agents of all actions. And one who knows that one is not the guna, or knows the ultimate reality which is not the guna, which is Brahman, gunatita, then that person goes and attains to the principle of Shri Krishna. The person attains my being, attains Brahman. The person attains Brahman or God. Gunanetan atityatrin dehi deha samudbhavan janma mrityu jara dukkaihi vimukto mritam ashnute deha samudbhavan, out of which this body is evolved. Etan, these three gunan, gunas, atitya, having gone beyond, janma mrityu jara dukkaihi, from birth, janma, mrityu, death, jara, decay or old age, dukkaihi, pain or suffering, vimukta, have freed, dehi, the embodied one, amritam, immortality, ashnute, attains to. So the embodied one, having gone beyond these three gunas, out of which the body is evolved, is freed from birth, death, decay and pain, and attains to immortality. So the person who is embodied goes beyond these three gunas. How? By transcending mind, transcending sense organs, by realizing one's true nature. That person becomes trigunatita, which is the nature of Brahman. Once that person goes to that state which is beyond the three gunas, that person goes beyond all the modifications which happen in this world to the body and the gunas, and attains to immortality. Amritam ashnute. Immortality. Ashnute attains. Now here Arjuna has suddenly one doubt. He says, Kairlingais trin gunan etan atito bhavati prabho. Kimacharah katham cha etan strin gunan ativartate. Simple doubt. He says, you are saying that a person who has gone beyond these three gunas will attain immortality, will go beyond pain, will go beyond birth, death, decay, will be freed from birth, death and decay. Now the question Arjuna asks is, how does that happen? How? So, Prabho, O Lord, Kai, by what, Lingaihi marks, Etan, these, त्रीन त्री गुणान गुणाः गुणास गुणान गुणास अतीतः भवति हैज़ गॉन बियॉन्ड किम आचारः व्हाट इज दैट पर्सन्स कॉन्डक्ट कथम हाउ च एंड एतान दीस त्रीन थ्री गुणान गुणास अतिवर्तते डस वन पास बियॉन्ड सो हाउ डस वन पास बियॉन्ड द मार्क्स ऑफ गुणास एंड हाउ कैन वन बाय व्हाट डस वन पर्सन गो बियॉन्ड दिस गुणास एंड व्हाट इज दैट पर्सन्स कॉन्डक्ट एंड हाउ डज दैट दीज थ्री गुणास हाउ आर दे ट्रांसेंडेड दैट इज द क्वेश्चन सो बाय व्हाट मार्क्स इज द पर्सन हु हैज गॉन बियॉन्ड थ्री गुणास नोन हाउ डू वी आइडेंटिफाइड सपोज समबडी इज कमिंग एंड टेलिंग आई एम त्रिगुणातीत एवरीबडी नाउडेज टेल्स दैट दे आर नोअर्स ऑफ गॉड एंड दे आर त्रिगुणातीत एवरीबडी इज अ गॉड पर्सन नाउ एवरीबडी is a saint today because of YouTube anybody can become saint or website etc very simple just have a website just have a YouTube channel you become a saint so everybody says that but how to find out who is the true person how to find by what linga linga means by what symbols or marks can we find out that this person is truly a person who has gone beyond these three gunas how to find out what is the kim achara hai what is the conduct this is similar to the question which Shri Krishna was asked by Arjuna in the second chapter sita prajnyasya ka bhasha samadhistasya keshava stitadi kim prabhasheta kim asita vrajeta kim so how does a person who is stita prajna act the moment Arjuna comes to know that it is possible to go beyond mortality. He is asking this question. Earlier also, in the second chapter he asked. Here also, when Shri Krishna says, Vimuktam amrit, Vimuktah amritam ashnute, Janma mrityu jara dukkaihi Vimuktah amritam ashnute, Amritam ashnute, that person attains to immortality, immediately Arjuna is asking, how will I identify this person? What are the features, what are the characteristics of such a person who has attained immortality by transcending three gunas? Also, what does that person do? How does that person attain this state? How does that person transcend these three gunas? So, for that, Shri Krishna is answering this question. He says, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, the Blessed Lord said, or Shri Krishna said, Prakasham cha pravrittim cha moham eva cha pandava. Na dveshti sam pravrittani, na nivrittani kangshati. Almost in the similar vein as he told the characteristics of Astita Prajna in the second chapter, almost in the same vein, He is saying, Pandava, O Pandava, referring to Arjuna, Prakasham, light. That is, light is the effect of Sattvaguna. Pravrittim, the effect of Rajaguna. Moham, delusion, the effect of Tamoguna. Pravrittim is activity. So, Prakasham cha Pravrittim cha Moham eva cha Pandava. Eva cha, and also, Sampravrittani. When they come forth, not dveshti, hates, nivrittani, when that is absent, nor kangshati, longs for. Now you see, even chains that are made of gold are chains. That is also bondage. Iron chains are also bondage. Golden chains are also bondage. So we have to go beyond, we have to break both kinds of chains. So a person who does not hate any of the gunas, does not also like any of the gunas. That person is gunatita. Means that person does not hate the appearance of light, activity and delusion. That means light is sattva, activity is rajas, delusion is tamas. So that person does not hate when that happens, also does not long for them when they are absent. So knowledge through the senses, sense organs, that is. So if knowledge is not there also, that person does not crave for knowledge. When knowledge is there also, that person does not hate knowledge. Similarly, when there is activity, that person does not hate activity. When it is not there, does not crave activity. When there is inertia, does not hate inertia. And when there is no inertia, does not crave inertia. So that means the person who is a person of wisdom or knowledge does not hate the effects of the three gunas and is not attached to the effects of three gunas. So that means the person has no attachment to three gunas or their effects. It is just like, so there is again this duality. So a person who is free from duality is the person who is Trigunatita. Essentially then, Sthita Prajna is a Trigunatita person. A Brahmagna, a person who is having the knowledge of Brahman, is Trigunatita. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.